Hello, this is Chris with Magoosh, and today we have an installment of GMAT Sentence Correction Tips, Tricks, and Strategies. And today's trick, today's thing to look out for is what I like to call hidden parallelism. Now, I'm assuming you already know what parallelism is. The point of this video isn't to go over parallelism, but it's to go about how the test uses concepts like parallelism and makes it really tricky and hard for us to figure stuff out. In this case, I like to call this instance hidden parallelism. What exactly do I mean by that? Well, let's dive into a question here and have a look. So here we'll notice this long, complex question. When I say complex, it has multiple moving parts and it's a compound, complex sentence, and a lot of it is also underlined. So a lot to wade through. Let me start off by reading it. For decades, the state government has been promising to construct a high-speed rail system between the state's two major metropolitan areas. And though some projects, like the laying down of small segments of track, have been started years back, several setbacks in the budget and in the actual execution of this work have stalled the project indefinitely. Okay, so as I said, a lot going on there. What do? We don't throw our hands up in despair. Even with something this long, the GMAT's going to follow its usual grab bag of tricks. You're going to have 3-2 splits. In fact, with this much of the part or of the sentence underlined, you might even have multiple 3-2 splits. So the first one that jumps out at us isn't necessarily the one that's right at the beginning. It's the though with split. No, that's a little bit iffy. That's not really a 3-2 split. But the thing that jumps out at me is that like. When I see like, after having seen hundreds upon hundreds of sentence correction questions, I think right away, okay, that's a like versus such as test. And when we have a specific example of something, in this case, the specific project is this laying down of small segments of track, then we know we need such as. And so just like that, we can get rid of answers A and answers B. Now, a little thing parenthetically here. When you see something that kind of sounds awkward potentially, the laying down of small segments of tracks, don't get pulled into that. Again, the GMAT's going to rely on its usual grab bag of tricks, and we here, again, homed in on the such as versus like split, and that leaves us with B, C, and E. Now what do we look at next? As I said, we're not going to focus on the laying down of small segments of track. We're going to look for something else that's different between B, D, and E. I notice were already started versus having been started. So this is a verb tense issue. And these can sometimes be a good way to approach the question, but aren't always as clear cut and sometimes force you to read the sentence over and over again to kind of sound it out or figure out where the noun is and which noun that verb actually relates to. So what we're going to do here is we're going to keep on reading. And we get to where it says several setbacks in the budget and several budgetary setbacks. That is, answer choice B has several setbacks in the budget, and C and E both have several budgetary setbacks. So just like that, I throw my hands up in the air and say, hallelujah, it's concision versus wordiness, and GMAT loves concision. The shorter, as long as it says the exact same thing, the better, and C and E both have several budgetary setbacks, which is shorter than several setbacks in the budget. However, that's the trap. Because we forgot that we always have to look at the underlying part, even if it's super long like this, in the context of the sentence. Look at the very end of the underlying part in the original sentence where it says, in the budget. If we read on, what's the next thing? And in the actual execution. Therefore, the parallelism is between in the budget and in the actual execution. We can't change in the budget to several budgetary setbacks because we get rid of that in there and we change the structure of that phrase so it's no longer parallel with in the actual execution, which is the part of the sentence that isn't underlined that we have to make sure that the underlined part matches up with. And so just like that, because we spotted this hidden parallelism, that is parallelism that happens outside of the underlined part of the sentence, because we were able to spot that, we don't even have to deal with either answer choice C or answer choice E. We've been able to eliminate them just like that and get the correct answer B. Which is great, because otherwise you would be looking at the with versus the though split. You might be confused there and spend a lot of time, and you might not notice the having been versus were, because again, there's a lot to wade through there. So hidden parallelism is yet another one of GMAT's tricks. It's typically not common at all in the lower and medium level questions, but you will see it when you start getting up to those harder questions that will help you get to the 700 plus level.